it's Sara, and what I'd like to do today is get us ready for our March art journal page. And I talked about that a little bit in a previous video, but what I was thinking was working with painted papers. I've been looking at a lot of videos. I've always loved collage, so painted papers kind of falls in line with that. You can just use any type of paper to collage with. You can just rip up scrapbook paper, pattern paper, you know, but making your own paper is really fun. And to do that, I'm going to use the jelly plate, and I have the big 8x10 one, or the 11 by however many. I got this one at AC Moore. This is considered the student jelly printing plate. It's 5x5, and I've seen this at Hobby Lobby too. But I just got these when I went to see Diane Reevely at her class in Maryland. These are the little mini ones, the petites, and I have circle, triangle, square. So I'm going to use these today too. You know, I try to use, I haven't used it, never used it, gotta use it. So we're going to talk a little bit about color and how we're not going to make mud, so I'll get to that in a minute. But first, a jelly plate is basically, it's called mono printing. So you're going to put color on this jelly. It's like a texture, it's like a gelatin type thing. You're going to, and you need a brayer. I think it works best with a brayer. So we're going to add the color with a brayer, and then we're just going to play around. We're going to make marks in it, and you don't need anything fancy. You can use the end of a brush to just make marks, but a lot of people use stencils and make your own stamps. You can use stamps. So we're going to play around with that, but let's talk a little bit about the types of papers that we're going to print on. And I had a question, I forget who it was, what kind of deli paper do I use? A lot of people, see, for collage, you don't want your paper to be too heavy because you're tearing it, ripping it, and layering it on your piece. So that's not to say you can't use heavy paper, and I've jelly printed on a lot of just white cardstock, plain old cardstock. But I'm now tending to just use printer paper, like regular printer paper that you would get at Staples, or these, I guess, vintage papers. This is a lot of the stuff that Allie sent me. I'm still trying to go through. She sent me a boatload of stuff. So that's really fun to jelly print on, because then you also get that cool writing in the background. So it's a double, you know, it's all good, right? So there are so many things. Now, she asked me, where do I get my deli paper? And I don't do it very often, but not that I don't. It's BJ's. BJ's is like a Costco or a Sam's Club. It's a club. And this is the deli paper that I got there, I'm pretty sure. I don't remember for sure, but it's by Markel, so that's a pretty common paper, you know, tissue paper type store, I'm sorry, place. So just, I mean, this seems to be your standard deli paper. It's not real waxy, and I think that's why people like it, but it has a tissue paper feel, but yet it's a little more sturdy than tissue paper, so deli paper is always a great option. So I'm going to pull out a couple pieces of that. I'm going to go through, and then I'm going to declutter my desk because I have a lot of stuff on my desk. So let's put that away for now. I have a couple pieces of that. Like I said, these are kind of vintage papers, and I have some hymnal stuff. This is music. This, I don't even know what this stuff is. It's journals. This is Lauder and Sons Company, so some type of a Court of Appeals, like maybe a law journal or something. Dictionary paper, always great, because then you can also tie it into your piece. Like if, you know, this is C's, so coupled, couple, countrymen, country, countless, but sometimes you can find a cool word and then feature that in your mixed media. You know, you can circle it and really bring attention to it. But dictionary paper is one of my faves. Now this, I'm going to open it right now. This is, I've never used it. I ordered it. I think Patty Totally Parrish turned me on to this. She's Inky Obsessions. But I didn't know much about deli paper and stuff like that, but she does a lot of overlay on her, she does, I want to say it's collage, but it's not collage. It's just color on top of color. But this is called Blick Tissue Paper. So I'm going to just take out a couple pieces of this. And I actually think this is probably better. And it was on, you could see I was storing it like this, so it got all wrinkly. No biggie. Tissue paper is, it will stick right down with your matte medium. So I'm going to put that aside. Kiwi's with me, so she's like, what the heck are you doing, Mom? What the heck am I doing with all this stuff? All right. So this is literally like tissue paper, though. But I just wanted to pull it out because I haven't, never used it. You saw me open it. Yeah, so this is definitely more like a tissue paper that you would put in a package. You know, that you would wrap your packages with. But it, evidently, it's really meant for stamping on. So what you would do on here is stamp words, images, different things that you then want to collage onto your maybe more focal point. So I may not jelly print on this, although let me cut this in half. I just want to cut it in half and get it more manageable, because our journal pages, this for what I'm doing, are only 8 by, they're only small. I don't remember how big they are, 6 by 8 maybe. So we aren't going to be working with a ton of paper. So you guys, you can jelly print on a little bit of paper. You don't need a ton. I'm just showing you what is out there that people use, and it works out great. So I'm just going to put this aside. I'm just kind of making a little pile so that I have stuff ready to go once that color comes out. And then this is, I've already cut this in half. I've been using this a lot. This is whenever you get a package, and I forgot to bring it in, but Joe has been ordering his lights for Christmas. You know, he's really trying to, well, you don't need to know that. Anywho, they pack it in paper sometimes, and actually there's a whole stack of it. It's a little more, it's white with like a coating on it. So I folded it all up and I saved it, but I want to cut it down into more manageable pieces. And we'll see how that reacts. And maybe even just crumpling it up and opening it up, you'll get wrinkly pieces and stuff. So, but this is generally what I use under, when I'm working with paint, or what I've been using when I'm stained glass, because it catches all the debris and stuff, and then I can just throw it away. But in mixed media world, you would want to keep these accidental pages, and sometimes you'll find some really cool stuff on here. So I think we have, oh, and then let me just show you this while I have it out here. Some stencils, but this is index cards, and this is some stuff that I've already done, and I made projects with these. These are just tiny little tags and bigger tags. I think I did these when I did the Kate Crane class. We use these in a little as an accent. You can always put these in your art journals and use them as pockets or tuck spaces or whatever. And then also, I just like the texture of a manila file folder. It's a bit stiffer. So if you wanted to cut a 2.5 by 3.5 piece out of this and make an ATC, you know, if you don't want to use it as a tag, you can do that. But look how pretty. This was working with the Diane Reevely sprays. So I made a few tags. But you can do, I'll just take a few out of those. And this one looks like it was just clean up. So maybe we'll use them. And then these are, like I said, the index cards. A lot of people do an index card a day. And I thought I was going to do it. And I had them. I had gotten these, oh, years ago, you know. And you dig out all this stuff, the stationary stuff that you have, to just play with and see if you'll, and I never did them. Well, I did a couple, right? A couple jelly prints. But I never made a project. All right, so that's a lot. Oh, and you know what else? This is just a plain old composition book. that this is where I wipe off my brayer. So you just kind of have this to the side when you're using your jelly plate and clean off your brayer between colors. And it's stuck. The page is stuck together. But you could, you know, if you like a little piece of that, you cut it out and you can use it. And then I would stamp, if I was stamping, I would stamp off on here. A lot of people have these little, see, and you just have, and this one had, look, metallic paint, reds and, or pink and oranges. And then when I was making my own stamps, which I pulled, what did I pull today? My dragonfly. I haven't been using those. I forget about them. They're right behind me in a drawer. So anywho, you have this. And, oh, I just pulled some. This is just, like I said, a piece of paper. I was probably just wiping off my brayer on here too. Did a few little strokey things. Because I want to talk to you guys. I don't think this month's page is going to be the intuitive painting. I think I'm going to skip the intuitive for today, for this month, and we're going to work on painted papers and collage. But the intuitive is coming because I want to talk to you guys about that too, and because it's something that a lot of artists, I'm doing Wanderlust this year, and more so than Lifebook. Lifebook is Tamara Labort's year-long like retreat. Online, this Wanderlust is so much intuitive, and so intuitive meaning just do whatever you want, like just slap paint down. And I am not a just slap paint, that doesn't make sense to me. I'm not feeling it, I'm trying to, and I think with a few rules of thumb it makes it much easier. So I want to talk about that, not this month though. For now we're just going to play with our jelly plates. So I have some bubble wrap, a couple of stencils, and I think we're ready to go. Oh, and graph paper. So I'll just take out a couple pieces of graph paper. This is actually, looks like a little bit of a bigger font. No, it's the same. Hi, Kiwi. I know I'm talking so much. I try to keep these videos short, Kiwi, because you know I'm a talker. Look at all this paper. All right. So the first thing we want to do is get some colors out. Paper, stencils. Oh, and I have this cool stencil. I think I got it at Stencil Girl. But it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different patterns, 7, 8, 9, 10 different patterns. So this is really handy to have if you're just going to be working in small spaces. And because I'm going to be using my mini jelly plates. Oh, she pooed. Sorry, let me wipe up that poo. That's not attractive, Kiwi. Why would you do that? Sorry. That's birds. Light for flight. All right. So, I want to talk a little bit about color because it's important. When you're working with a jelly plate, you don't want to make mud, right? Obviously. And so the best way to not make mud is to know a little something about color and basically just to work with either cool or warm. And I learned this in Diane's class as well. Let's go in a little bit. Hopefully I won't forget. Sorry, I got a sniff. So here's a color wheel. This is a pocket color wheel. By, I don't know, what, so there's tons of them. You can get these at any craft store in the art department. And right on here, it talks about color. So you have your primary colors, which are red, yellow, and blue. They're the basic colors, and they cannot be made from mixing another color. So they are created that way. Secondary colors are when you mix the primary colors, you create orange, green, and violet. Tertiary are when you take each made by mixing one primary color with an adjacent secondary color. Now, this is what I wanted to get to, the warm and the cool. And this is what Diane talks about. In her classes, she will put all of her sprays and her paints, any type of color, pigment, in separate containers. She puts her cool colors in one container and her warm in the other, and that way there's less chance of making mud. So their warm is considered reds, oranges, and yellows. So any form, and I wrote that down here, red, orange, yellow, and green, blue, violet. So we're going to work with red, orange, yellow, or any, so pink, orange, and you know, you can tweak them, but keep it in that warm, warm being like the sun, right? So think of the sun, red, orange, yellow, that's like the sun, warm. Cold is blue, like the water, like ice cold water, right? Green, blue, violet. But you can tweak them, so you can go green. These are all in the green family here. These are all in the blue, violet. Am I in the shot? And then, so you have your red, orange, yellows, all these go together. You're not going to make mud. All right, so as long as you know that, then you, and all you need is three colors. Just get a red, orange, and yellow, whatever you like, and we'll play with those first. And then we'll do some green, blue, violets because they are oh, and then you can always add black, white, or gray. You can add a neutral to either one of those. So you can add some black, you can add some white, and you can add some gray. All right, so that's how, and you won't make mud that way. So the complementary colors are opposite. So if I then, once we've made our pages with these colors, we're gonna do cutouts and make different shapes of these and add them to that, okay? So what I'm thinking we're gonna do is we're gonna make a background probably with our green, blue, violets, and then we're gonna cut out little, we're gonna do a bird and a branch and some leaves and stuff like that. So this is what, so you'll have homework maybe. Make up some pages, and I'm going to go through it. You don't have to have a jelly plate. You can use your nonstick mat, you know, because it has that kind of like, you know how Tim Holtz does it, right? So even if you want to do the Tim Holtz technique where he puts out his sprays and then he dunks the paper in there, you're going to get cool colors. Just make sure you use, you don't make mud, right? So if you don't have a jelly plate, do that. Or you can use, let me go back out because I know I'm zoomed in and I always forget and then, yeah. And plus you can see a little bit of kiwi. But what was I saying? So yeah, just even using your brayer, you can just squirt a few colors on here and just use your brayer on here and then take a paper and make a little jelly plate, right? And then after, maybe we'll go back with some stenciling. So don't worry about the stenciling right away. You can add layers after, okay? So first we just wanna get some background colors down. I think it's simpler this way, or I may just do a, you know, when I use my little one, I may just do a couple ghost and whatever. All right, so I'm going to come back with a part two. I just wanted to talk about preparing to jelly print. I'm going to clear my desk and get ready for actually jelly printing because I have a lot of stuff on my desk, and maybe I'll think of something else. No, I think we're good. But like I said, I'll do both ways. I'll do it with the jelly plate and I'll do it on my craft mat, and we'll just put color on a page. I'm going to get a piece of probably mixed media paper in the size of the art journal pages that we're working on. So I want to talk to you about that. And so I'll be back, all right? So that was it for now. I know it was a lot and I talked fast, but you know, I'm trying to make these videos a little shorter. So I hope that helped and I'll be back. All right, thanks for watching. Hello, it's Sara, and I'm back for part two of what I'm hoping will be our March art journal page. I'm going to do some jelly stamping, jelly printing. So these are our journal pages, January, February. These two are from February. Valentine's and February. So I'm working on, for the art journal, right now we're making painted papers. So that's what this video is going to focus on. And then we're going to come back at another time and make a journal page using the papers that we make today. So let me just stick them aside. And that would be, so I'm probably gonna do a background today. on a piece of, this is, I believe, mixed media paper. And I've cut it down. I just got the pad. And this is 9 by 6. Because I cut a 18 by 12 inch paper in half. Something like that. I don't know what I'm talking about. You know, a pad. Anywho, so I will probably jelly print on, these look very uneven. I didn't cut this in half very well. So yeah, a jelly plate is this gelatin plate. And I got these two little ones when I went to my class in Maryland with Diane Reevely and haven't used them yet. And that's why I want to use them. And then this is the student gel printing plate. It's 5 by 5, so I'm going to work on this today. Because our page is small, you know, I figured I could use these smaller ones, so we're going to use those. This one you can get at Michael's in the art department. I think I saw it at Hobby Lobby, too. The minis is this one. It had a circle, triangle, and a square. They're 3-inch shapes. And I've seen people play with these. See, look what you could do. You can make like a pattern. So maybe we'll just stamp out some colors, and I don't know. So I reviewed in the previous video the types of papers that I like to print on, and also that we want to stick with either warm or cold colors, and that way we won't make mud. So I'm going to get started, and I'm going to do my warm colors first, so red, orange, yellow. And I've just picked out a couple different versions of a red, orange, and yellow. So I have a fuchsia, more of a, these are both pretty similar, the yellows. One's an opaque yellow, and that's called cadmium yellow. Country red, and then this is a neon orange, so a torrid orange. I just wanted to see. And you don't have to use all the colors on one, but I'm going to put a couple of different, I'm going to go with pink. I love pink and orange so much. But these are considered warm. Think of the sun. And then you're just going to roll it out on your jelly plate. And then I'm going to roll it off on this big piece of, it's like a, the paper that they wrap your stuff in when you order something. And then I'm going to take a piece of, say, like, let's do this big piece of, what is this, a dictionary? And I'm not even marking it. I'm just getting color down. Like, because you can put marks in it. And let's just do a ghost print on the other piece, on the other side. And I was saying how I like to jelly print on a more, like a less thick, I used to do it on cardstock, but then I just started doing it on printer paper, because when you do collage, you can make it too thick. It's hard to work with the thicker you go. So let's change it up and go with red, yellow, and orange and see how that looks. And I'll do a different piece of paper. Let's just do red and orange. I don't know what that's going to look like. Sorry, Curb. Kiwi's with me. And let me roll it off over here. And let's use this book page. You know, at this time I'm going to do a little bit of mark making. I have these big stamps that I got, and I hardly ever use them. So I just put a couple flower marks on there. See what happens. And let's do a ghost print on this side. See? So I got those little flower marks on there. And I'm just creating some color palette. So this is my my warm color palette. So I'm going to just stick that aside. Let's try red and yellow. For orange and yellow. Let's go orange and yellow. I like that fluorescent orange and yellow. This is just craft paint. This is Americana. You can get it at all the different craft stores. And I lost a lot of my orange, but that's okay. I also wanted to show you how you could do this on your craft sheet. So I'm going to do a piece of deli paper. Let's put another mark on here. I have this other big stamp. It's circles. Or kind of like, yeah, I guess it's circle-y. And then I'm going to take that and I'm going to go back on the original pink one that we did. Oh, my circle got stuck to it. And just stamp it on there. Can't really see it. Stamp it off because there's color on here. My other jelly plate. Stick it on there. It's not showing up. All right, so I'll take that and pick up that color. So that would be great for a sun, you know, like if you're going to make a sunshine. And I'm just trying to grab the color off of here, clean off the jelly plate with this ghost print. I'm very messy. I got my little, I'm going to put my little circle on my little square. So we're going to keep going, make a couple more, let's see, look, these are going to be gorge. Maybe I should put out a couple more of these. At least one more. Anywho, red and yellow. Did we do that? I think we did red and orange, yeah. No, with pink and orange and red and orange. So I don't know. I don't remember now. And I have this cool stamp that I've never used. It's a Bohemian roller stamp. So I'm just going to roll this off in this area here. Clean off my briar. Got a little chunk there. So I have this, where is it? This thing. I'm just going to roll it on here a couple times and make stripes. Never did that before. And then what kind of paper? Let's do it on this side of the deli paper. So basically I'm just trying to get a little stash of color that we can use for our, so yeah, you can see those lines in it, that we can use for our art journal page. There's a lot of Kiwi, you want to come up? Come on. What's mommy talking about? That's my bird. All right, like one more. Let's do some more pink. I wonder if pink and red. Let's do pink and yellow. What? Tell everybody what you're thinking. Oh, this is a lot of paint. Don't forget, you know, it's a lot of paint. But, oh, there's a bubble. Dry paint. But you can basically just take this then. Let's do it on this graph paper. And roll it off. And then we're going to do another book page. I'm going to do another. I don't know where my book pages are. Oh, a music sheet. It's like hymnal paper. I think it's a hymnal. Allie gave me these. Allie gave me all this antique paper. And I'm trying to use it up as best I can. Look at that. So gorge. And these are wet, so I'm just putting them aside to dry. But I think we've made a good assortment of cool colors for now. I have this red one. Maybe I need another red, because these are pink. We got this on the deli paper. Is that red? That's red and yellow. A nice yellow one. Maybe I'll just do red. I have another sheet of hemnal paper. Oh, look, what's on here? Oh, I have a lot of pink, because see, I love pink. So I tend to, and then look at this. This big piece is super awesome. So I think I'm going to go with a red with a pattern on it. And I want to add a little yellow to it too. I'm watching the clock because I'm going to go for a walk run tonight with the group from Herbalife. See, that would be great for a flower or a sunshine. I'm going to put it on here. It's almost like the red kind of, it turned peachy more than it's red. But let's do, I have other mark making things here. I want to make a mark with this, my circles. I love circles. And they're super easy to work with. So I've just made, am I in the shot? Yeah. I've made some circles. I'm going to stamp these on top of this red. You know what, I'm going to do it on the yellow. And see what happens. Cool, right? But I have this. This is two of my favorite lids. I have this big Snapple lid. I know this isn't Snapple. This is my iced coffee. So I'll put that on here too. This is my Snapple lid. So this might be going a little crazy with the circles, but we shall see, right? And then I'm going to take, I'll do the hemnal paper. So what was that, red and yellow? Yeah. I love it. You can't really see those, this circles as much. You saw them much better on, I want another piece of deli paper. Don't know where I put it. I have a couple more of them. I have deli paper right here. Just to get this ghost print. You gotta really push hard sometimes to get this to come off the. Alright, I think we're gonna move into our warm colors. So I'm just gonna take a baby wipe and try and get this off. So for my warm colors, I have go-tos. Like, I love this lime green, but I also pulled this lavender. Now, the warm colors, I'm sorry, cold colors, green, violet, and blue. And it's on your color wheel. If you guys just get a cheap color wheel to remind you, you'll never make mud if you mix those colors. But if you put warm colors with cold colors, you can make mud. And then you can always add black, gray, and white to either of these. So maybe I should have gotten them out. I forgot. That would be so cool. Where's my white? Here's white. And I guess black. We'll see. Alright, so let's add. I love like a turquoisey blue. It's so pretty. And I may do my journal, my art journal page. How about purple? See what it looks like. These are Fran's colors. I've been doing a lot of stained glass, and my cousin Fran painted her bathroom that blue color, and then she accented it with turquoise. I'm sorry. Purple, violet. And I just think it's in my head right now. Now that, I lost a lot of the, a lot of the violet. The violet didn't really show up. No worries. Let's do, I have this as like a flip. Oh, let's do this. This is a piece of corrugated paper. And I'm just going to lay it across and push it down. And then I'm going to put it over here. That is so cool. All right, and I have another piece of dictionary paper. Hi, Kiwi. Second print on top of that would be better. I'm just going to put my hot colors over here for a sec because I want to be able to grab stuff quickly. I used up a lot of my papers. Oops, I have another deli paper. All right, we're fine. And I still have this one. All right. So now let's pick. We just did the light, and really that's all we use. So let's go darker. The lavender just didn't show up. Hi, Kiwi. And my lime green. Let's see what this looks like. It's a lot of paint. I keep forgetting I'm on such a small little... put my brayer. Yeah, that's a lot of paint. I'm gonna do this again. Looks cool, right? I don't think I can get much of a ghost print because that really... Look at all that got pulled off. That's crazy. Let's do more of that. I love me some purple. Let me try and find a better lavender because that metallic... Here we go. This is called Summer Lilac, but that metallic just wasn't showing up. So I wanted to go with lavender and like how about a darker green. Let's see, because I want to do leaves. I'm just going to do a little bird for spring. Boy, March came in like a lion for sure, but we're almost there, guys. We're in the home stretch. Boy, that's an let's pick this up. Watch this. You can pick it up off your craft sheet, maybe not as well as I hoped. Yeah, I fell off. Oh, I'm a klutz, what can I tell you? That is an interesting combination. Like lavender and green. Wow, I haven't really done anything like that before, I don't think. But it didn't make mud. So as long as you stick with those color families, you'll be fine. And who knows what can come of that little, you know, that could be an interesting floral situation. All right, what else? I got this sapphire blue. And I'll do light blue. I'll do the sapphire and the light blue. Oh, that was a lot. I like using metallics a lot, but I'll come back with stenciling and do... wow, I am putting way too much paint. Just FYI. Let's try one of my little, I'm going to do this circle. Since I have so much paint, I'm going to do the square too. I have a ton of paint on here. Oh, dear. Well, I just jelly printed my chair on the way down. Paint happens. You know what I'm saying? Paint happens. What are you going to do? There's a lot of paint on there. All right, let's do this. I can't wait around too long. Let's put a little circle of blue on here, but first let's, no, I'm good. Just go with the blue, because see, it's already, I just love, that color blue is gorgeous. I'll put it with this. And see, it kind of came off the jelly plate, but it looks good like that. All right, so we have this big piece of, it's like a ledger paper or something. Some type of lawyer paper. Allie gave me these. Thank you, Allie. I didn't make it all the way. This is going to be a good goose print, so I'm going to go on this jelly paper. So this could be like sky and ground, right? But look, so cool. All right, so we're getting there. I think you get the idea. You want to just keep going around. Now, I haven't added the white or the black. I kind of want to see what black will do. I want to put a tiny bit of black with this blue and see what happens. I don't want to overdo it. But sometimes you might want a little, and maybe we'll use a, let's see. Yeah, I could use a stencil so it won't be so, that's a lot of black. We'll see. Watch. Let's see what happens. I don't want it to turn totally black, which it kind of did. Not totally. I do want to use a stencil, and they're all buried. Or, look at this. I have bubble wrap. And I'm going to go over one of my cool color pages, like this, maybe. Put it on there. I'm probably way too, am I in the shot? Yes, oh good. So actually that makes it better because it's not totally black, but I wish I had put more blue. I'm going to do it again. I'm going to use this lime green. And mostly lime green and a tad of black. And do the same thing. I think I'll use, that's so much paint again. Oh my gosh, what is wrong with me? Look, it's like stripes. I'm keeping it like that. I need a piece of deli paper. Not deli paper, this stuff. No, not this stuff. Hold on, I have a lot more over here. Look at that happy accident. All right, and then I think I'm just gonna go with this onto, let's do a piece of, this is a like index card. And a little piece of this. It already had some blue on it, so what the heck? Well, that didn't work out. That's really cool, though, isn't it? Oops. I'm just running out of papers to use. And I don't want to mess up some of the cool stuff I've already done. Oh, here's a good. All right, so the second part of this is going to be to add some details with stenciling, but using the same colors. I want to get that black off there. All right, so I may, let me see. You know what though? I really wanted to use these guys and I haven't. What am I going to do? What am I going to do? So here's purple. This is very cool. This, not so much. I just kind of on that one. All right. So these are all my cools. I don't want to get black on everything. Did a little bit of black, didn't we? Yeah, we did. A little bit of cool and warm on that one. Kiwi, what's the matter? You want to go back to your kennel, to your cage? You're meeping. Come here. You want to come up and see what we're doing? What's the matter, Bubby, huh? This is a little bit of red. Let's go with some white. Make some white circles on things. Maybe I could give them a little texture or something, but let's just see what happens. Am I in the shot? Because I know I'm like all the way. Yeah, I'm in the shot. Okay. Really like these. All right, so I'm just going to take this, and it didn't even really stick that good, but I'm just going to go bloop. And there's a little black on it too. Bloop. I'm going to make this white with, oh, I know. I don't want to ruin that one. That's so pretty. Let's do this one. Probably should have put more paint, but that's okay. Circles. Let's try to get these circles on here. Looks cool. I think I do want to do that to here. That's a shame. This got like black on it, but it doesn't matter because we're going to add other stuff. And it has black in the background because of the words. So what about, let's just do like red and white. And see what that looks like. One dot of red, one dot of white. How good? Well, I gotta eat. Okay, that's a lot of paint again. I like it though. I'm gonna hit this little guy here and here. And I'm gonna do this again, try to make, and then where was I gonna go with this sucker now? Oh, over here. I wanna go like right here since it's a circle, but let's see if it even shows up because it was on the same color. Eh, bad idea. All right, so you get the idea. Because this just takes, and it's all hit and miss, so I should be speeding this up, and you don't have to go through it with me real time, but I like you guys to see me doing it, my mistakes. It's not always, you know, a hit every time, so just do it. Whatever's happened, happens. And at the end, you're going to divide out some of these, and we're going to start to add complementary colors and a little stenciling. So I'll come back and do a separate stenciling video, and we're just going to use the papers that we made and adding the same bits of color, cool and warm, and try to fill these in. And I'll probably go back and do a little more printing on some of them to get them more filled in. But look at this one. The brighter one is never, it's always good stuff. So even if you just have a brighter and you don't have a jelly plate, just roll it like I have pallet paper, roll it out on your craft mat, and just get some good mixes of colors. I love how the brighter puts down color. And then look at this. You have all your mark making tools that I could still be playing with, so it's endless, you know. So I think we got to start, and then maybe we'll just collage our whole background. That's an idea. I think I'm going to do that. So we'll go with some of the blues up here and some of the greens down here and make a background, and then we'll make a red bird, you know, and the trees and stuff, so it'll be cool. All right, so get started, make some jelly prints or just any kind types of paper backgrounds. You can do this with scrapbooking paper colors. So I'll be back and we'll get this March journal page done. All right, you guys, thanks for watching.